We have lit again the two candles in our Advent wreath to remind us of God's gift of hope and peace. Today we will light the third candle, the pink one, representing joy.
Isaiah says, "Everlasting joy shall be upon their heads." The third candle reminds us of our joy in Jesus Christ.
As we wait for Christmas, the birth of Jesus, we look forward to the joyful celebrations we will share with those we love. The prophet Isaiah calls us to rejoice because God will make the desert bloom and will call his people to return home on a great highway. When Jesus was born in Bethlehem, the angels brought good news of great joy, which shall be to all people. The good news of Jesus' birth and the promise of shalom are still things of great joy for us today. Let's pray. Dear Father, I thank you so much for this day of worshiping you through praise and song. Hope was born that Christmas morning long ago that brought joy into the world. Father, I pray that you would open our hearts this morning, that we each would come to know that joy, the true joy, the everlasting joy that is found only in your Son, Jesus Christ. In Jesus' precious name I pray. Amen.
Let's go to the Lord together in prayer. Father God, we praise you for who you are, for all that we've already experienced, for that which we are about to experience, Lord, from your hand. We thank you for all things that you have provided for us. But more than any other thing, we thank you for Jesus, our Savior, our hope. Father, it gives us joy to return gifts and offerings unto you, for you have given everything to us. We are so blessed, and we come here today for the purposes of worship. So, Father, we ask that you would bless the gift and the giver for the glory and the furtherance of your kingdom, that all things said and done would bring glory to the name above every name, Jesus Christ. In his name we pray, amen.
angels sang and the heavens rang with tidings of great joy. And on that night an ancient spark had journeyed from afar. The greatest gift that God could give became the Christmas star. There's a light that shines on everyone, burning brighter every day. For the souls who search for peace on earth, it's the Christmas star.
In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was with God even in the beginning.
long ago, God offered a message of hope to a weary people. To those walking in darkness, God spoke of one who would bring the light of truth. To people bound by oppression, God spoke of one who would release the captives. To a world marred by sin, God spoke of one who would redeem the lost. While the people expected a mighty king or a strong warrior, God's answer resided in an infant's birth. Imagine the hope of the world cradled in his mother's arms. Emmanuel, the one spoken of by prophets, hailed by angels, and welcomed by shepherds. From heaven's throne to a stable's manger, his coming altered history. His birth touched humanity. His life changed eternity. The word's hope revealed by heaven's light. This is Emmanuel.
Thank you.
Word became flesh and made his dwelling among us. We have seen his glory, the glory of the one and only who came from the Father, full of grace and truth.
Emmanuel, oh, the hope that abounds from that name. God near us, God among us, God with us, but above all, God's love revealed to us. Imagine the one who wove creation's fabric with the most intricate of beauty, born in a stench-ridden stable. Ponder heaven's king sleeping in a borrowed manger. From the humblest of births, God so loved the world that the one who created us came to us to mend what had been broken and restore what had been lost. From a crowded stall to that lonely cross, he came to show the way to everlasting life. On that holy night so long ago, as angels sang of his birth, God's matchless love was revealed for the whole world to behold.
suddenly a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to those on whom his favor rests."
From the time the angels sang that first chorus to our own outpouring of song today, Christ's birth is still the ultimate hope for a broken world. At a time when God's people were looking for a warrior or to overthrow a nation, God sent a Savior to soften people's hearts. God's redeeming work began with a single birth on a silent night. And from that glorious moment, the peace we long to see cover all creation is the peace that first flows from the human heart.
The shepherds hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby who was lying in the manger. When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what had been told them about this child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said to them. But Mary treasured up all these things and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things they had heard and seen, which were just as they had been told.
That holy night so long ago has changed our world. Heaven and earth colliding in a moment of awestruck wonder. For those walking in darkness, a new day has dawned and a new life has begun. For those worn thin by the concerns of the world, Jesus is the lasting hope of God's eternal plan. For those who grieve in the weakness of their souls, Jesus is the surpassing joy of a faithful God. For those held captive from rest, Jesus is the abiding peace of a new tomorrow. For any who have wandered from the path of God, Jesus' perfect love calls us home. As we celebrate his birth, we join with the company of old in proclaiming our joy, a joy shared throughout the world, a joy offered for the world. Rejoice, for a Savior has been born. Rejoice for lives that have been redeemed. Rejoice, for God is with us now and forevermore.
Rejoice, rejoice, rejoice.
Praise the Lord. Thank you so much, choir. What a great gift to the Lord you guys have just done. Thank God. Aren't they awesome? Didn't they do a great job? They really did. Praise the Lord. And what's most beautiful about these folks behind me is they did it for Jesus. That's who they are. And that's what they've done today. We just praise God. I know I do, and all of us do. Praise God for how He's spoken to us through the message of music. His love and His purpose for our lives. And how beautiful. How beautiful that is. Jesus Christ came into my heart. And He changed my life. Jesus Christ is my Savior. He's my Lord. He's my King. In one day, in His time, I will enter into His very presence by His grace. And the singing that we've heard today is a prelude to the eternal worship that many of those that we love are already experiencing. And one day, for those in Jesus Christ, we will join in that heavenly choir, lifting up our voices to give praises to the King, the King of kings and the Lord of lords. And we want no one to miss that opportunity. But there's only one way to heaven. There's only one way to the Father. And that's through a personal faith relationship with Jesus Christ. There is no other way. There is no other way. Only through Jesus. You see, we're not perfect. We fall short. Every one of us. But that's okay. Because Jesus Christ is perfect. He's the spotless Lamb of God, the eternal Lamb of God. And He laid His life down on a cross at Calvary 2,000 years ago. And in that, He changed the world. But it wasn't just His sacrifice. Many great men and women have sacrificed their lives for good causes and for others. Jesus Christ, the very one who was born in a manger, the incarnation of God, we celebrate this time of year. This music was all about. Jesus Christ is risen. He is our almighty risen Lord. And our hope, our prayer. I've been praying for you. We've been praying for you. Is that if you've never surrendered your life to Jesus Christ as your personal Savior and Lord, that you would do that. If you were to die today, do you know for certain you'd go to heaven? You know, when I ask folks that question, most of the time the answer that I get is, I hope so. The Bible teaches us we don't have to hope. We can know. 1 John 5:13, you can look it up. We can know that we have eternal life. And no one should go through life not knowing. Because that's the epitome of insecurity. So please get that settled. Please get it settled. What a beautiful message through music today. It was all there. The narrators, you did an awesome job, Sam, Lane. The choir, filling in backing up that truth in music. Praise God. Praise God. We want to have a time of an opportunity, a hymn of invitation, a time for you to come and to respond openly and to give your life to Christ. Or maybe God is calling you to rededicate your life to Him. Now's the time. It's not next week. It's not next month. We don't know. We're never promised tomorrow, but we have today. So you come. If you've never given your life to Jesus, if God's calling you to rededicate your life to Him, you come today. Would you please stand? Would you come lead us, Sherilyn? Blue is going to come and give our benediction in just a moment. Sherilyn, we thank God for you. I don't know if I've ever met a more dedicated, a more committed Christian than Sherilyn Ammons. I love you and I praise God for you. She gives and gives and gives. And many of you know, even through difficult times, David and Sherilyn have experienced. The response has been giving and giving and giving. And we praise God. Thank you, Sherilyn. Love you.
As you may know, well, I know you know this, that Northgate is all about, even this morning, sharing the good news of Jesus Christ, and is all about fulfilling the Great Commission and sharing the name of Jesus through to the nations. And so one of the ways that we do that through the Southern Baptist Convention is we give to the what we call the Lottie Moon Christmas offering. And I just want to remind you about that's a way that we can give, and our goal as a church is $10,000 to share the name of Jesus to the nations. That money goes straight to the International Mission Board, and so we are so privileged and blessed to have that as a convention. And another way that we have been sharing the name of Jesus to the nation is through Operation Christmas Child. Many of you gave boxes full of gifts to be shipped to the nations. And we sent 20 people last night, 17 students and 3 adults, to Charlotte, to the processing center to ship boxes. And one thing that we got to do, which you maybe you knew this, but our students, instead of shipping boxes, took T-shirts that were donated by companies or even universities like Nike, like Furman, and bundled those up, and those get shipped as well as another way of ministering to people. So that's what we did last night. But all the boxes that went out during our shift went to Peru. And so this morning, as our benediction, let's pray for Peru and the ministry there. Yes. Oh. Yeah.
You folks have been awesome. Stepped up to the plate to help with that. I think I have 5 children's names remaining.
Wow.
I started out with 41, I think it was. Somebody said there's no way we can take care of that. We have had 5 we couldn't locate. But we do the best we can with that.
Awesome.
If you would consider yet responding to that need, let me know, and I will see that you get the name of the child to sponsor.
So if you didn't hear Will, there's 5 children that could be sponsored for Angel Child, and so that we need. And Northgate has already taken, 37 or so, something like that. And we praise the Lord for that. Let's pray together. Father, we thank you for the great testimony of your love for us that we've heard this morning, that God is with us through Christ and by your Spirit. And I thank you that we get to take part of sharing that message. And as we leave today, may we take opportunities this week to share the hope of the gospel with our neighbors and family and with our coworkers and with our classmates. And Father, we thank you that these Angel Child children have been adopted by Northgate. God, we pray that the needs would be met, but most of all, we pray that Jesus would be seen and heard. And Father, I pray for Peru. We lift up that nation to you this morning. God, may you be sovereign over everything, over every gift that's given through Operation Christmas Child. May you use these boxes in specific ways that points to you and your glory. May your message of hope be shared, and may men and women, boys and girls, be saved. May you bless the churches in Peru. God, allow a great awakening to come to that nation. In Christ's name I pray. Amen.